If you know anything about me, you know that I adore anything related to Mary Poppins. Whether that's the books, both of the films, the stage show, the umbrellas. I love them all. However, film two, released only a couple of years ago, is Mary Poppins Returns, with Emily Blunt in the lead role.
Time for a good, clean start.
And what a wonderful job she did of it.
Thank you very much. Yes, thank you.
A very different interpretation of Mary Poppins.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
The thing that is most obvious to anyone watching it that loves the original film from the 60s is the choice of accent that they gave Mary Poppins in the second film.
Quick march and best foot forward, and I'll thank you not to dawdle.
It was a lot more posh, a lot more clipped, but to be perfectly honest, Mary Poppins Returns is set 20 years later, and it was indicative of the times. In the 1930s, people did speak with a slightly more sophisticated accent. But it's a slightly superficial 1930s accent, and Mary Poppins is all about getting things correct. Sadly, Emily has some rather blunt vowels.
How incredibly rude.
Here is the first example.
Off we go. Some pirates follow treasure maps and wear a silly hat. They search the world for buried gold. They won't grow up and don't grow old. Can you imagine that?
Now, in received pronunciation, which is what Emily Blunt's Mary Poppins is attempting, that word, G-O-L-D, should be pronounced gold, not the slightly coarser gold.
They search the world for buried gold. They won't grow up and don't grow old. Can you imagine that?
Now, again, incorrect pronunciation of the word S-U-R-E.
Be sure to scrub behind your ears.
Emily's Mary Poppins says sure correctly. It's sure. Sure. Not sure. Sure. Later on into the film, they go inside a cherry bowl, and Emily Blunt does get the pronunciation of bowl correct. Which is unusual, because half of her vowels are blunt, but then some of them are correct. In this example...
Which of you broke the bowl?
Bowl is said beautifully. We want bowl rather than bowl. But then later on in the song that follows, it all goes to pot.
Yes, in this dilly-dynamical, simply ceramical, Royal Dalton bowl.
Bowl?
Which of you broke the bowl? Royal Dalton bowl.
Bowl.
Would you help us?
Similarly, during the song, she says hole when it should be hole.
There's a cuddly and curious furry and furious animal watering hole where the monkeys and hummingbirds know the tunes and the words. Every beast, large and small, loves the very top drawable, always encorable Royal Dalton music hall.
Hole. Hole.
Ooh, that one tickled my tail.
Indeed, the title of this very song, Royal Dalton Music Hall, which is how they pronounce it, should be Royal Dalton Music Hall.
Royal Dalton Music Hall!
Here we are!
In effect, what's going wrong is that Emily is doing monophthong vowels, which is where the vowels have one sound. But correctly, in received pronunciation, all of these words that we have covered are diphthongs, which means they have two sounds. Really, knowing good received pronunciation is entry level when it comes to being an actor.
Now tread lightly, this is fine porcelain and we don't want to chip the glaze.
Side note, nothing to do with pronunciation, but Royal Dalton have never produced porcelain, they have only produced fine bone china. So it's not porcelain, and again, I'm slightly disappointed that Mary Poppins got that wrong.
Complete nonsense, of course.
However much I may just have picked apart Mary Poppins' accent in Mary Poppins Returns, it is a phenomenal film, and I highly recommend that you watch it. I have watched it at least 478 times in the last month alone.